If you are new to the channel, then subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for further notification.
Okay, student, welcome you all to this new lecture in Power System series. So today again, we will be solving 5 questions starting from question number 216 to up to question number 220. Okay, then let's try to solve these questions. So in question number 216, out of the consideration 1 to 4 listed below, the consideration which constitute advantages of HVDC transmission. So you have to find out which one is the advantage of HVDC. So no distance limitation related to steady state stability. This one we have seen, because the steady state stability improves in HVDC. So there is no distance limitation for that one. For AC we have a distance limitation. For DC there is no distance limitation in that purpose. No reactive power requirement from the system at the two terminals. Now this is not advantage, because it is not correct, because there is a reactive power requirement at the two terminals, because in DC link you cannot flow your Q, only P can be transmitted. So Q cannot be transmitted, so in the rectifier side the Q that is coming that should be absorbed, and the inverter side you have to supply Q to the load. So that is not correct. No substantial effect on fault level at the two system at the terminals in spite of the interconnection. So if you interconnect two systems, so there is no, with the HVDC, the fault level doesn't change so much. So there is no substantial effect. So again 3 is correct, because that is not linked with fault level. Fault level is different concept. Fault level current will increase, but that will not change any substantial effect. No, there will be no such effect. No corona loss. No, there will be corona loss in DC, but the thing is how much it will be, that is different, but corona losses will be there. So 2 and 4 are wrong things they are saying. This is not correct. So your answer is 1 and 3. That is your option B, 216. Now if you come to 217 again, choose the appropriate auxiliary components of HVDC transmission line. DC inductor, yes, in HVDC link, suppose this is your link, this is the HVDC link, this is suppose rectifier and inverter, whatever. So this is the link suppose. So in the link we provide an inductor. Why this inductor in series? This is DC series inductor. This is provided to reduce the harmonics in the line. Because of this rectifier and inverter, there will be harmonics in the current. So inductor will doesn't allow that sudden change in current, thereby it's reducing its harmonic content. So this is given to for reducing harmonic content. AC line inductor, in AC side there is no line inductor. Reactive power sources, yes, there are reactive power sources provided this side also, this side also. I have told you, in one side it will be absorbing and one side it will be delivering reactive power. You will need somewhere to absorb the, because PQ is coming from this side. You are supplying P only, and here also PQ requirement is there, but you are sending only P. So this Q has to be consumed here, and here you have to supply Q for this load. So this is not correct. Oh, this is also correct. 3, this is also required. Distance relays in DC line, no, this is not given distance relays in DC line. That is not concept of that V by Z concept. What is distance relay? We have discussed in protection system. So that is not required in DC line, or this is not given in this DC line. Series capacitance, no, there is no series capacitance. There may be shunt capacitor, because reactive power requirement is there. So shunt capacitor or other sources of reactive powers are given. So that's why it is your DC line inductor and reactive power sources. That is your 1 and 3. So that is option B, 217 again B. Now if you come to 218, HVDC transmission is mainly used for, so you know this one, very bulk power transmission over a very long line. When we will use HVDC? You cannot use HVDC everywhere. We can use, but it is not economically viable, because for small line, small power, economic cost will be more higher than your transmission, then your net output will be negative. It means you are spending more than you are earning less. So that's why HVDC is used when you want to transmit very large amount of power over a long distance. So in that case, if you invest more also, that will give you good return. So that's why bulk power transmission over a very long distance. So A is the obviously answer. We can read out others also. Interconnecting two systems with the same normal frequency, no. Generally, it can be done, but it is not the advantage, or mainly not used for this one. It is used for two areas. Suppose they are of different frequency, 50 or 60 hertz. Suppose it is intercontinental or inter-country it is connection. So in one country it is 50 hertz frequency, in another country it is 60 hertz. So you can provide a HVDC link here, because the converter and rectifier, you can easily tune it to 60 hertz here, you can tune it to 50 hertz here. So in between there is a HVDC link. So that can be done. So that is generally done for different frequencies of two areas. Eliminating reactive power, no, reactive power requirement is, it is additional requirement, it will require extra. So it is not eliminating it, it rather require more. minimizing the harmonics in the no, it is giving rise to harmonics. It is not minimizing, it is giving rise. So it is obviously option A. Now if you come to 219, in a HVDC link consists of a rectifier and inverter, transmission and other equipment, which of the following is true? The transmission line produces supply reactive power. We can see we have already drawn this one. So in the transmission line there is no PQ, so A is wrong. No Q is produced, no Q is consumed. So the rectifier consumes reactive power and inverter supplies reactive power. You can see this is your rectifier side, because from this side you are sending power, suppose this is your load, suppose. So this will be rectifier, this side will be inverter. Here AC will be converted into DC, and here DC will be converted back into AC to give this load. So which is consuming reactive power? So from AC side we are supplying PQ, but P can only go through this side. So Q should be consumed in rectifier. So rectifier consumes reactive power, and here load is required PQ. So you give something Q from this inverter side, so that it supplies this load Q, because Q is not coming from this side. And inverter supplies reactive power. So inverter side you have to give some supplying reactive power. So obviously you can see this is option B. No need to read for C and D. It is same supplying or receiving. This they are interchanging the languages. So 219 is also B. Next, if you come to 220, two regional system each having several synchronous generator and load are interconnected by an AC link, also a DC link. Both link are there, AC and DC. Which of the following is true in steady state? So there are two regions, AC and DC. Both regions need not have same frequency. No, it cannot be, because you have AC link. When you have AC link, this frequency should be same. If there is no AC link, only DC link, then frequency can be different. No problem. But you have, as we have an AC link, so these two, so option A is wrong. Total power flow from a PAC plus PDC can be changed by controlling HVDC converters alone. So if you change these converters, the power flow here will change. So if here it is reduced, then here it will increase, because this side power depends on the voltage magnitude and angle, voltage magnitude and angle. So if you have a fixed V1 delta, V2 delta, so your power flow is fixed, how much power should flow from this side. So if you change this one, the power flow here, it will reduce, but then power will be increased here. So the total power will always remain fixed. If you reduce this one, it will be increased, because net power flow from this to this side doesn't depend on converter. It depends on V1 delta and V2 delta, the angle of this side. It is V1 angle delta 1, it is V2 angle delta 2. So the power flow depends on these two, voltage magnitude and angle. So once this is fixed, whatever change you do in your controlling angle, firing angle of this thyristor, the power flow here will change, but the same power, if it is reduced, the additional power will flow from this. So total power will be always remain same. So B is wrong. The power switching between AC and DC line can be controlled by HVDC converter alone. This is correct. If you are changing the firing angle, the power flow here can be reduced or increased. So that change will be nullified by this change. If it is increased, it will be reduced. If it is decreased, then it will be increased. So the total power from here to here remains same. So that's why it is option C. The direction of HVDC can be reversed? No. This cannot be true, because the power is flowing, that will be, because the power flow from this side will be always fixed. So that's why it is option C. If you like the video, then press the like button and please give your valuable comments in the comment section.